Much of reclamation steel infrastructure is pushing a 50-year or 100-year service lifetime. This is a big thing that we're asking from our steel structures. So one of my jobs at reclamation is to try and get these service lifetimes by preventing corrosion on our infrastructure.
Most of this is steel infrastructure with an organic coating to protect it from corrosion. Those materials have started to degrade, and they're now at the point where they need to be replaced. However, the replacement materials that we're using are not up to the same quality that the materials we originally used. And this is because of health and safety concerns of those old materials.
Corrosion on submerged steel structures is a problem because when you are submerged, you're in the presence of electrolyte, which makes corrosion more likely to occur. In the Army Corps of Engineers, it's especially a problem because a lot of our hydraulic steel structures stay submerged for long periods of time, years at a time, without being exposed and inspected. So if you have corrosion occurring, you don't know that it's going on, and it can be a large problem.
Corrosion on submerged steel structures is a problem in our industry because it creates a loss of revenue and a loss in cost of labor as well to find and implement solutions to try and prevent our structures from degrading.
The best corrosion protection system for our steel structures at Reclamation is a combination of protective coatings and cathodic protection, and these have worked for us for a long time. However, as our infrastructure ages, we're needing to do more and more maintenance, replace our coatings more often, replace our anodes on our cathodic protection systems more often, and this results in a much higher cost to Reclamation.
Some of the coatings, depending on the environment, may only have a 20 or 30 year life. On a radial or tainter gate, it can be much less than that. And so the structures have to be taken out of service in order to be recoated, and that's very expensive.
The original materials that were applied to our structures gave us somewhere in the range of 50 to 100 years of service, depending on the material that was used. We're now using epoxy and polyurethane coating systems as a replacement. However, the service life that we're seeing is much, much less.
We hope that prize competition can help us solve our corrosion problem by opening this problem up to a broader audience and bringing in new ideas from people who maybe have tinkered with rusty nails or different structures in their garages, but have never really looked at this from a scientific standpoint and can still bring really great ideas to the table.
This prize competition is seeking methods to protect our steel structures from corrosion for more than 50 years. Specifically, we're looking for protection in service environments that are typical of the fresh waters of the United States.
The benefits to the Corps of Engineers for improved corrosion prevention systems would be twofold. One, we have aging infrastructure. In some cases, it's beyond its design life. If we could help maintain that so that we have longer life with less maintenance, it would be less downtime that would affect commerce. And also, we're having smaller budgets, so it would save the taxpayers money in order to maintain these facilities.
The ideal solution for this prize competition would be one in which we could achieve a very long service life, 50 plus years, decreased cost, and less maintenance.